So lymphatic drainage of the abdomen. Lymphatic drainage from most deep structures and regions of the body below diaphragm converges to collection of lymph nodes and vessels associated with major blood vessels. Yes, so what does it mean? And they later get all to the thoracic duct. So generally, as we look at the picture below, in this picture we took all of the abdominal organs from it. Yes, so now we see the blood vessels. Blood vessels are on the very posterior of the abdominal cavity, so they are just anterior to the vertebral column. What is the and both big arteries and big veins are here. What's also important, those small green lumps and the green lines, and those structures are the lymph nodes and lymph vessels that are associated with those big vessels, and they are here in the posterior of the abdominal cavity. And then the lymph is predominantly drains into the thoracic duct. Some from the abdominals of the surface of the abdominal wall is draining to the axillary nodes, but most is getting to the to this area. So when we approach the aortic bifurcation, the collections of the lymphatics associated with the two common iliac arteries and veins merge. Yes. So obviously when we get more superior and superior, closer to the thoracic duct, we need to converge in order later to collect all the lymph into the thoracic duct. And generally, those lymph nodes, yes, because the lymph vessels of course are getting through the section of the lymph nodes, which are anterior to the abdominal aorta, is just anterior to the abdominal aorta, they are lying on the abdominal aorta, and right and left are lateral aortic or lumbar nodes, yes? So the para-aortic nodes. Para-aortic nodes because they are close to the aorta, which are positioned on either side of the abdominal aorta, as we have seen in the picture, So we have these pre-aortic and para-aortic nodes. And we have some main lymphatic vessels, yes, like the right jugular trunk that has the right head and the neck, yes. This is the lymphatic drainage generally, yes, of the organism, the main lymphatic vessels. We'll get to the abdominal cavity specifically in a moment. Left jugular trunk, left side of the head and neck, right subclavian trunk, right upper limb superficial region of thoracic and upper abdominal wall. Left subclavian tract, left upper limb superficial regions of the thoracic and upper abdominal wall. So the same, yes. Right bronchomediastinal, right lung, bronchi, mediastinal structures and thoracic wall. And left opposites just on the left. And thoracic duct, this is the most important, obviously. So the lower limbs, abdominal walls and viscera. Pelvic walls and viscera, thoracic wall. Yes, so a lot, generally, nearly all. This picture already can be seen. So, and now we told that most is getting into the thoracic duct immediately. Yes, but now lymphatic drainage of the anterior lateral abdominal wall. We have superficial lymphatics above the umbilicus that pass in a superior direction to axillary nodes. Yes, so this is important. Although those are generally closer to the inguinal nodes, okay, quite closer, they will get to the axillary nodes, yes, so they will travel quite a bit. Drainage below the umbilicus passes to the inferior direction to the superficial inguinal nodes, yes, so one more time, it's stressing how important are both the axillary and inguinal nodes. Deep lymphatic drainages follow the deep arteries back to the parasternal nodes along the internal thoracic artery, lumbar nodes along the abdominal aorta, and external iliac nodes along the external iliac artery. Lymphatic drainage of the abdominal part of the gastrointestinal tract. So the lymphatic drainage of the abdominal part of the gastrointestinal tract, as low as the inferior part of the rectum, as well as the spleen, pancreas, gallbladder, and liver, so generally all of the organs of this upper part, is through the vessels and nodes, eventually getting to the pre-aortic lymph nodes at the origins of the three anterior branches of the abdominal aorta. So What do you need to remember? That those organs are generally getting to the pre-aortic lymph nodes, generally to the generally to the lymph nodes that are around the aorta. Okay. These collections are therefore referred to the celiac, superior mesenteric, and inferior mesenteric groups of the pre-aortic lymph nodes. Yes. So in this case of the lymphatic drainage of the abdominal part of the gastrointestinal tract, it is a bit complicated. Yes. So it does not get all to the. Okay. So. Getting back to the topic, we have these celiac, superior mesenteric, inferior mesenteric groups of the pre-aortic lymph nodes. How do we think about them? We think about them, those lymph nodes are getting all of the way over the aorta, but the celiac nodes are just close to the celiac trunk, yes? And the other nodes are also close to the other groups of legs to the aorta. You do not know the main branches of the aorta, I suppose, but generally the main branches of the abdominal aorta are the celiac trunk, then we have the mesenteric, superior, and the inferior arteries. We have also to the sides, we have the renal arteries and some others. And next to those arteries, we have the, just next to those arteries, we have the lymph nodes. Yeah, I don't have words today. Okay. So we have next to the superior mesenteric arteries, celiac, as I said, the most superior is the celiac trunk, then superior mesenteric artery, then inferior mesenteric artery, and so on. Generally, of course, near the hilum, so near the place where the blood vessels are getting into the organ, we usually have also a lot of lymph nodes. Yes, so we have different stages, different groups of the lymph nodes related to the organs. Yes, so in case of the gastro, in case of the stomach, we have the gastromentalis, for example, lymph nodes. We have the generally. Some special lymph nodes that is related to pyloric. We have some splenic lymph nodes that are also correlated with the spleen and some to the stomach also. We have lymph nodes related to the splenic artery and these lymph nodes related to the area of the aorta of the celiac trunk also. Okay. And here we see just the stages, yes, so I do not want you to learn all of those lymph nodes where they are, just you need to have an idea that we have some stages of lymph nodes, yes, so it gets from one to the other, to the other, to the other, and generally it ends in the lymph nodes near the aorta, and those gets further on. But the organs are generally, the lymph from the organs is generally getting in this direction to and up, yes, to the aorta first, to the lymph nodes near the aorta, and then up in the direction of the thoracic trunk, and then to the veins on the border of the neck and the thoracic and the thorax. Okay, and here we have the one more time, the generally the idea, for example, where are the lymph nodes on the pancreas, yes, and you can see the vessel, these are getting just next to the vessel, and we have different stages, yes, of those lymph nodes of the pancreas, so superior, inferior, yes, we have some mesenteric, as I said, one more time, the most important arteries are the celiac trunk, superior, inferior mesenteric arteries, and there are more, but for now those are the most related to the area that we are. And next to those arteries we have the next to those arteries we have the lymphatic nodes. And this is about the female genitalia, where it goes. Of course, we have the superficial ones that goes to the inguinal nodes, yes. But of course, later it gets further on. And from the deeper organs, like the uterus, it gets to the iliac nodes that are on the sides, and then, of course, all gets to this area. So it gets generally like those big vessels. In case of the testes, it's a bit more complicated because the testes are differently organized. The lymphatic drainage is getting primarily to the these pre-aortic and para-aortic lymph nodes. About the generally for the ureters, well, ureters are important because the cancers of the ureters are not so uncommon. They can happen. And for this is just the example, yes, I did not need to know exactly this, but the upper part of each ureter drains to the lateral aortic lumbar nodes, middle part of each ureter drains to the common iliac vessels, inferior part gets to the external iliac vessels. Yes, so this is just a way to think about this, that all is connected anatomically. Yes, so the superior one drains to most superior lymph nodes. The lower we get, the lower are the lymph nodes, yes, simply speaking. In most of the cases, of course, not all. And those cases that it was not true, we already stressed. Lymphatic vessels from the deep parts of the perineum accompany the internal pudendal blood vessels. Yes, so one more time, we have the blood vessels, and if you know how the blood vessels goes, you would probably also know how the lymphatic vessels goes. And where are the lymph nodes? Okay, about this we already told. So as you can see, this generally goes from this perineum, from the scrotum, into the inguinal lymph nodes. The only this difference is that the testes are just getting immediately into the pre-aortic, para-aortic, sometimes to the iliac, but generally it's get deeper, yes? It does not get here to the inguinal nodes, yes? So the testes are different a bit in this area. Okay, thank you very much.